And so, ironically, we come back full circle, and that law that could only arouse sin in us now appears beautiful to us, and yet at the same time can no more give us power in sanctification than it can in justification.
And so we grieve when we don't keep the commandments we know and love.
Because we love the commandments, but we continue to break them. And the law has the same relationship to us in sanctification that it does in justification.
Well,
we are no longer condemned, so we can love it, and yet we still break it.
It's interesting to see how Paul now views his righteousness, now that he's in Christ. And then he attempts to do those things that God has required of him in the law. And now, in Christ, as he looks at his own performance, instead of being, you know, exalted, he's debased. It's like, oh my goodness, there's no good in me whatsoever.
What a wretched man I am.
And yet, ironically, that leads him back to Christ.
Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ, the Lord, who has given us the victory.
It is the grace of God that teaches us to say no to all unrighteousness.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And isn't that what Paul says here at the end when he says, oh wretched man that I am, who will deliver me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ. By looking at himself, he is in complete and utter despair. What else? He's just described, by the way, another reason this has to be Paul as a Christian. He only looks at himself. When he looks at himself, he only finds despair.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same moment, and only a Christian does this, at the same moment, he spies his Savior at the Father's right hand and says, now I can look up. Not because of the utopianism I have about me, but because of the utopianism I have about him. And it's not utopianism. He is already vindicated, justified, and glorified at the right hand of the Father for me. Rod, earlier you mentioned the character Brooks from the movie The Shawshank Redemption. The interesting thing is that Morgan Freeman's character's headed down that same path as Brooks, which leads to suicide. But why doesn't he?
Hope.
Yeah.
The redemption was accomplished for him, wasn't it? And it initially communicated to him by way of a promise. Go to the oak tree and look for a black box.
Yeah.
And that's the way it is with us. We don't yet live in the consummation, but the age of the promise.
Yeah.
We have to always go back to the black box, and the place we do that is the Word and the sacraments. That's where we spy Christ, who restores our buoyancy, who restores our hope, who makes us lift our chin up.
Yeah, the counsel to look within is the counsel of the 20th century, and Luther couldn't have disagreed more. To look into the self, Luther said, you're going to find nothing but death, despair, sin, and everything else. He would have none of sort of self-measurement for improvement, you know, keeping a checklist and see if, compared to yesterday, on where am I today, or any of that. One of the ways in which the reformers defined sin was curved in on self, the incurvitas in se. And the only cure for it, one way of seeing justification, is God bending our backbones straight for the first time in our lives to point us outward to look to Christ instead of inward. And in the 20th century, boy, that's hard for people to hear, because everything says look inside for the answers. Yeah,
so that makes a big difference if you think that the essence of sin is being curved in on ourselves, and the essence of Christianity is looking outside of ourselves
to Christ,
then that means we have to define sin very differently, because evangelical spirituality today is curved in on ourselves.
Yep.
But what you're saying is sin in its essence is to be curved in on ourselves, not just to be actively engaging in promiscuous behavior, but for us to look promiscuously outside of the one to whom we've been married.
This is really gospel, and those who've tried it will know what I mean. To finally be delivered from the promises that looking at self, if you do it the right way, will help you along and up. And those who've tried it and tried it and tried it, and it's done nothing for them, I'm saying, and I think this is straight St. Paul, quit doing it. Quit doing it. Find a pastor who will turn you, by means of the Word and the sacraments, to Christ outside of you. and particularly Christ in his dying, Christ in his priestly work on the cross, and you'll enter a new world.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a witness to that, yeah.
Boy, yeah, same here. Me too.
Yeah.